We've never anaesthetised an eel before, so normally they're very wriggly, they're very hard to get hold of or get close to and have a look at.
And I thought, unless we're making a video in
there. So hard to see
them. My name's Julie and I'm one of the ectotherm keepers here at Auckland Zoo. So today we're x-raying one of our longfin eels, or tuna as it's known in Māori. It's got a small bend in its back, so we're just going to see if we can x-ray and ultrasound and see what's going on.
So we're just getting the water set up for the eels. So we've got one body of water that's going to have the anaesthetic in it, and then a second without anything in it for it to recover in. And this is the water that the fish is used to. Julian and the rest of the ectotherm team know the range that the eel is comfortable in, and we're going to generate the warmer half of that range, which means that the eel will cope with this anaesthetic a lot better. So we're mimicking what it might do if it swam into the shallows of a pond where it's a bit warmer on a sunny day like it is today.
So the longfin eels we have here at the zoo, they arrived about 9 years ago. We've got 11 currently in our big pool in the wetlands aviary. With the eel we x-rayed today, we noticed the slight bend in its back turn up, and then it looked like it was getting a little bit worse. So we pulled it off show, so we're holding it in a special kind of medical tank to allow us to monitor it. And then having the vets come down and do these procedures means we can hopefully figure out how to make it better.
The thing we've just poured in is the anaesthetic that's dissolved in a little bit of warm water, and then we're adding it to the 500 litres of water that the fish is in now and mixing this round so it's all evenly distributed. They're breathing in the anaesthetic with the water and then they're absorbing it through their gills. And the drug that we're using is basically the active ingredient in clove oil. If you were here with us, you'd smell the smell of clove oil, so the stuff that you put on your gums if you've got sore teeth. And because we've not done this procedure in a long-finned eel before, and I'm not too sure that many people have, the exact dose and the time is a bit of an unknown quantity at the moment. So we're going to watch now, but this could take, as I say, 20 or 30 minutes for it to achieve a nice level of anaesthesia. I'll try and cradle it back in. And here a bit. Yeah, do you want to just cover its head slightly, looking in the dark? We'll run away.
It's very rare for us to x-ray anything that lives in the water. How can we get it to stay still but still make sure it's nice and healthy to be able to get these images? So it took a little bit of planning, but luckily longfin eels have the ability to be out of the water for periods of time. It's an adaptation they have, so it's a little bit easier for us to do this with the longfin eel than some other species.
That's the heart. You see the heart moving? Contracting in the middle of the screen. Ultrasound scanning a bar of soap.
So we had quite a crowd today. We had a few keepers come in who might not have been working with the eel today normally. But it's one of those things, it's always really interesting if something's been done for the first time. So the eels, their main threat is habitat loss and destruction. So we have some issues with fresh water quality in New Zealand. Our streams and rivers aren't always doing that well, and they also need to migrate to the ocean to breed. So if we put impediments in place, so if we put dams or culverts or things in the middle of a river that stops them getting downstream, then it actually stops them breeding. So that can be a real issue, as well as the water quality and habitat loss.
So, a problem,
so we'll hopefully get a better image of this on the high def screen back at the clinic when we're in a dark room, and just see whether there's some bony damage here. Mm. It certainly doesn't look like a fracture.
Okay, cool, cool.
This is a procedure that's new to us at the zoo. As far as we can tell, this is the first time on record that anyone has done an anaesthesia and x-ray on a longfin eel. But actually the process that we used on the longfin eel to us zoo vets is a very tried and tested method in other fish, sometimes even sharks and rays, but our opportunity to do it on
native freshwater fish is very limited, and this is the first time we've done it. And actually, having done the procedure, I think it went really well. Quicker than we thought it would, and as good as we could have expected. So this is the side-to-side view. This is the top-to-bottom view, and then this is the vertebra, the bony bits in the middle, and you've kind of got muscle on top, and then abdominal contents here. This is the swim bladder. You've got this curve in the spine, so that's not normal. And then we've got collapse of the space between the vertebra as we get to where the lesion is. So there's no fractures in the spine, so there's no evidence of trauma. One of the things that we think can cause this in fish is low vitamin C. You know, vitamins can go off with time, so we just need to go back and review the way in which we're providing vitamin C and make sure that that's as good as it can be. And then the outcome of that investigation will lead us to an action or to go down and investigate even more. That's the next step, really. So I guess this is the start of the investigative process, and it'll be another few days until we know the end result.